What's going on, gamers? It's Dreamkillers representing Mad Mastermind. First Friday of the new year. Hope everybody is doing well. We're on the road to the top 10 using the Dallas Cowboys. You guys know the deal. Bill Walsh under center spread. Blueprint on defense trying to lock up. Our opponent, once again, here is using the Denver Broncos, running that five-wide ghost scheme. And we both started off pretty rough. Fortunately for us, we made a key first adjustment on the first drive. Got up the touchdown after throwing the interception on the first play of the game. So that was good stuff there, but then he burnt me. So we're tied up 7-7. This actually turns out to be a pretty good game. So definitely stay tuned to the end. I think pretty sure it comes down to the last drive. So yeah, that's that. We'll talk about the game here in a minute, but I just wanted to quickly, briefly touch on the free scheme that we're working on here. I played a game yesterday, and I think what I'm going to do is film room style. Let me know down in the comment section if you guys don't mind just seeing the defense. If anybody's master members on the website, that's sort of what I do for the film rooms. For anybody that bought the blueprint, they only saw a defense, the adjustments, and you know what I was, the plays I was running, the adjustments I was making, just saw the defensive side of the ball. And then for master members on the website, we have film rooms, which are the full games, where we talk both sides of the ball, all the play art, everything, pretty much the full hour-long game or 45-minute game, whatever it is, and we go over that. But as far as like the free scheme, I just want you guys to be able to focus on the defense. Unfortunately, in yesterday's video, we weren't able to run all the plays that we were trying to. We're hardly even able to actually get into the 3-4 odd, but I'm definitely going to... Dang, man, my eyes. I'm definitely going to be trying to do that here in tonight's game around 8. Might start dropping as far as, like, I wanted to do, like, a quick mini-scheme type tip where I show you guys the run D and a couple of the blitzes that we're going to be using in the game. I had already posted the 2-4-5 buck slant 3, so again, for anybody that hadn't seen that, definitely go and check it out. But then I started labbing yesterday just to, you know, double-check a couple things, again, kind of going back to my perfectionist ways. And again, is there anything that's 100% in Madden? I'd say no. But at the same time, you know, I was just labbing the run D and just making sure that it was as good as what I was thinking it was. And I ended up finding something better in 3-4 over. So let me make sure that it's right. I'm going to still do the film room type defense thing tonight as far as the 3-4 goes, so you guys continue to see that scheme develop. And then as soon as it's 100%, it'll be available. You guys can start integrating the blitzes in the scheme as soon as you feel comfortable with it. You know, if you see something good in the games, you know, obviously we'll be able to note it during the game, see if it's working or not. So, yeah, definitely stay tuned for it, man. I just want it to be right, man. And, you know, somebody had said, you know, thanks for throwing it out there, man. I've been wanting to do it all year. It was just a matter of time getting stuff accomplished and getting some, you know, my ducks in a row as far as, you know, stuff for the website. Stuff like that. I still don't even have my offensive scheme out there, so I'm lacking. But again, 2015 is going to be a year to follow through, so I'm definitely going to step my game up, man. So definitely stay tuned. If I don't hit you guys with two videos a day, there will definitely be a video a day from me. And then again, maybe Ghost or Mav will be able to jump on. I think Mav might be good for Monday, Wednesday, Friday in the near future. I'm going to talk to Ghost a little bit later on this evening, see if I can get him to commit to a day, just so you guys have some variety. More so than what I'm doing. You know, obviously Mav runs his stuff. Ghost always has something unique for you. And, you know, that was part of, you know, what the goal with the Mad Mastermind channel was, to kind of give you guys, you know, several different points of view from, you know, above average, you know, if not really good players. So you guys could just see all kinds of different things. I'm stubborn because I'm old. You know, Ghost, he always has something unique on offense. Mav's always switching up his scheme. You know, he does run the blueprint on defense, but, you know, he'll switch his offense up, even though, you know, his flat line's his main thing, but he said he was getting bored of that, so he was going to be trying some new stuff. I don't ever get bored of running, you know, my half a dozen plays, so I'm just trying to win. I feel like it gives me the best chance to win. To a certain degree, you know, somebody else had commented how much better I'd be if I ran more plays, but I think for me, it's part of my challenge. So, you know, some guys that put down their punt on fourth downs or third downs or try to win kicking field goals, I'm trying to win and get to the top 10 running one formation, man. So hopefully, I don't know if you guys could see from my point of view, I feel it's a challenge. I do feel it's a really, 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 really good formation, if not the best in the game, in my opinion. But at the same time, you know, it just challenges me more to, you know, be creative, make my reads and stuff like that. And I think that's why I think it's a formation that's been holding true for so many years now, because, you know, a spread scheme with a run game is very difficult to defend because you're trying to commit to certain things, especially as blitzes become more popular, you know, throughout the year. I can kind of get a grasp of what the opponent could be doing. You know, if they run max coverage, as long as I'm patient, the reads will still be there. So, again, that's pretty much my deal with that. Now, dipping back into this game a little bit, you can see here, time's ticking down 3 minutes or so here. I was locking him up, man. I must have had a zillion drop picks in this game. But nonetheless, he stayed tight in the pretty much the entire game. I mean, he was had a pretty bad deficit at one point, but he worked his way back. You can see 28-21. My receivers still aren't holding on to the ball. I figure, what do I got to lose? Throw a terrible pass. I don't know. That was supposed to be to Murray, I thought, but it wasn't. Anyhow, first play back out, he would hit me with the wide receiver screen. And yes, I got defense for it. You probably noticed he hit me with that quite a few times. But he was running like a 5-wide set with two running backs. And what was happening there is every time that I would come out in a formation more apt to stop that play, he would audible down to like single back ace or some other formation to run the traps and stuff that aren't going to give me the best chance for run defense. So it was kind of like pick your poison. So it was a good scheme for him. I think he was ranked in the top 50 as well. But good for us that we had him run out of timeouts, kick the field goal in the last play of the game, get the dub. So we're keeping moving with the road to the top 10. I'm Dream Killers representing Madden Mastermind. Hit the like button if you guys enjoyed the video. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter, DreamKillers843. And we'll catch you guys a little bit later on this evening. Appreciate it.